only thing faster than light is the darkness.
Hey guys, welcome to Mojo at the Movies. I am Rebecca, and I was very lucky to see a preview screening of A Wrinkle in Time with my colleague and sister, Emily.
Hello!
Welcome.
Yes, I was lucky too.
Yes, we were very lucky. So, we're going to tell you three reasons why it was overhyped.
Yeah.
But first, we're going to tell you why we liked it, but then we'll tell you why it was overhyped. So, there were a lot of things about this movie that worked.
Yes.
So let's talk about those first. What was the number one thing that worked for you?
I thought it was visually one of the most beautiful films I've ever seen. I thought the CGI was obviously really, really good. They did so much cool stuff with the worlds, but also they filmed on location in New Zealand. And of course, you don't really need to edit New Zealand, as you know.
Yes, I've been to New Zealand. It's very lovely.
Excuse me. And so I really liked the worlds that they explored, and I thought it was very visually beautiful. The costumes obviously were really nice.
I know. We were trying to figure out what could we wear that would look like them.
I'm metallic like Oprah.
I just went with colors. But anyway, there were a lot of other things that worked in the movie.
What'd you like?
I thought the acting really made the emotional impact for me. So obviously the three Mrs. W's were Oprah, Reese Witherspoon, and Mindy Kaling. I thought Chris Pine was really good. I saw on Twitter somebody overheard at the movies. Chris Pine is the most versatile of the Chrises, and I think this movie actually does kind of prove that point.
That's true. Yeah, he does a lot with a little, I feel.
Yeah. He's, spoiler alert, he's not in the movie all that much. But that is kind of the premise of the movie.
It's okay.
Anyway. Also, this is one of those movies that is coming at an important time.
Yeah.
You know, the themes, you know, fight dark with light. You know, yay science. You know, it's a sci-fi movie with a female lead.
Yeah. A diverse cast.
Super diverse cast.
Yeah.
Ava DuVernay is the director, and she is already an Academy Award nominated director, if I'm not mistaken, of Selma and the documentary 13th, I believe. And, you know, she's kind of a record breaker for a lot of reasons for this film. And again, I think a lot of these things worked, but let's go into the things that worked less well, or were overhyped.
Yes.
So what would your number one reason this movie was overhyped be?
I think even though like the book was written back in the 60s, it's being heralded as the next big, best coming-of-age movie for kids and stuff like that. And that like being compared to some of the most beloved properties that like we love and
everyone loves. I had seen one of the producers on the film, her name is Catherine Handon, apparently she read the book when she was a kid, and she's been trying to get it made for 54 years.
Yeah.
And she was involved in the 2003 TV remake
of
it.
Yeah, she even thought that fell flat.
Yeah, and she thought it fell flat. Anyway, she called this a cross between The Wizard of Oz and Star Wars.
Yeah.
So, those tall are the, order.
Yeah, insane. I feel like it's great, and I think it does a lot of the classic hero's journey thing. I'm about to go into my degree.
In liberal arts.
Yes. And the hero's journey, like the call to action and stuff like that was still very present in it, but I feel like a lot of people could say it's derivative with that sort of like advertising behind it, that it's the next classic, basically.
Yeah, I feel like there were moments in the movie where I was like, oh, this reminds me of that, this reminds me of that.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's good and bad, because, you know, nostalgia is good, but derivative is not as great.
Yeah.
Now, the book, when she was shopping it around to publishers originally, it was rejected like 26 times or something.
Yeah.
Because they all felt it was too complicated for children. Now, I felt they simplified it. Would you say they went too far?
I think there is one way in particular that they simplified it that I was kind of bummed that they did, which was not exploring the other world as much. There's like 1 second where you see the other planets that you could explore. And that was a really interesting part of the story for me, and I really wanted to see that explored more. I mean, they got rid of entire characters, and ultimately I think I agreed with those changes, but I still think that all the subjects that they have to combat, they have to talk about science in an actual factual way, they have to talk about a coming-of-age story, they have to talk about the nature of good and evil, and the nature of love, and the nature of family. Like, I'm stumbling over all these things, but that's all things that they're talking about and trying to give due time to, but like, that's so much. That's a lot to deal with.
Yeah, it kind of, I don't want to say this, but it kind of reminded me of how the Justice League tried to jam in a lot of stuff.
Right, yeah.
I think it does a valiant effort, I just don't think it's mm-hmm. quite there.
Yeah.
Now, the selling point for a lot of people of this movie would be the Reese, the Mindy, mm-hmm. and that up-and-comer, you might know her, Oprah.
Yeah.
Do you think that does a disservice to the film?
I think a lot of people would probably go to see it because they're in it, and that does a disservice to how awesome the child actors. Storm Reid does a fantastic job as the main character. Mm-hmm.
And her little brother is really good, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. He was so multifaceted, mm-hmm. I found. And I was like, he's a child. What's going on? And, yeah, I think that a lot of people would be disappointed to see that the misses are in it less than the trailer would have you believe. And, yeah, like, it's fine. I got my Oprah motivational speeches. I'm good.
I'm there for that. So I hope that doesn't dissuade you guys from seeing the movie too much, because it does succeed on a lot of levels. It's very visually and emotionally impactful. But like we said, it does have its issues. So see it this weekend on March 9th. Thanks for watching, guys.
Thanks.
Your father's trapped by evil energy.
It's too strong for our light.
And the only one who can stop it is you. Be a warrior.